for it. 20.
20? Happy?
Happy.
Alright, sending out. Right down.
When people think about reef ecosystems around the world, they're most likely going to think about coral reef ecosystems in the shallows. But what we're here to look at with the Inkfish program is slightly beyond that, into the mesophotic zone. Looking at 30 meters down to 150 and asking basic questions like, are they different? If they are different, then how are they different?
So we should be stopping about here.
One of the fundamental principles of science is to be able to say things in general about why natural phenomena occur. One of the core parts of that is being able to replicate the same experiment many times. To then be able to say, are things occurring by chance, or is it due to some underlying mechanism by which those things have occurred?
So the BRUV is a simple idea of just two camera systems sitting inside a metal frame on a rope, which goes to the seafloor.
We've got two cameras in a stereo arrangement, which allows us to measure the lengths of fishes. And that information can then be converted into biomass. And that's what's really key for assessing fish stocks and getting an idea of the status of fish populations in nations like Samoa.
It could be a silver tip shark. It's a juvenile, obviously, but that's really rare. We haven't even seen that before.
Yeah.
We've deployed 185 deployments so far. My favourite deployment has been in 80 metres on the north coast of Savai. We landed it on about a school of 300 to 400 snapper, all just roaming around both in the water column and on the benthos. When you multiply that out to weights and tonnages, it's got to be almost a ton of fish. And I've never seen that many fish in one place before. So when we go to a new place and deploy these BRUVs, we are often pushing the needle further in terms of what we think we know about a species' depth range.
On the previous leg, they had come across a hole-like feature just off of the north west section of Savai. As far as we could see, we couldn't see it in historically publicly available data, so it could potentially be a new feature. It's actually quite unusual to find a feature with such straight sides as this hole does. So it's almost a vertical cylindrical tunnel that goes into an otherwise flat section of the seabed.
It's a lava plug, we think, and it goes from 60 metres down to 140 metres, which is probably quite interesting habitat for fishes. It's been called the Mordor, the Pit of Doom. So we're going to go see what lives down there. I had an inkling that there might be some fish in there. I'm just currently filling in my metadata for a 140 metre drop, which is the deepest yet. Hit a fish, I'm very excited. It's going to be awesome. Okay. Happy Sean, you on the plug?
Yep, we are on the plug.
Okay guys.
Right.
Good to go.
Let's go.
Slowly forward, Sean.
Up and down. I think we got bottom.
Bottom!
Yeah, bottom.
We have entered the plug. Yeah, slightly forward, not too much though, nice and steady.
Yeah, just hold it.
Yeah, lovely, Sean. Good work, guys. 5 meters.
Yeah, cool.
Surface. Hello, my pretty. Camera's recorded. It's a good thing. Oh, school of jobfish. These are Pristipomoides filamentosus, I think. Whoa, it's heaps of them. The most jobfish I've ever seen together. Wow. Whoa. We're only 10 minutes in as well. We've got 60 more minutes. Whoa. Whoa, barracuda. We've just hit our deep drop, 140 meters, and we've seen a big school of jobfish, which is a really important commercial target species throughout the Pacific. So places like Tonga and Solomon Islands have asked us to look for them specifically. So it's great to see them here in Samoa as well. And I haven't seen them in such big numbers here, which is awesome, ever really. This is our deepest drop by a long shot, by at least 40 meters. Certainly makes us more excited as a group to start chasing some of those deeper drops down to 150 meters. That's technically where the mesophotic zone finishes and is a really important transition zone between there and the rarefotic zone, which is 150 to 300 meters, which is where we've been hitting in the sub. It would be nice to shorten up that difference in depth between our two methodologies, being the baited remote underwater video and the subs. Alongside the BRUVs, we've been using stereo video on the submersibles as well. So we've had a special bracket made up, which are exactly the same as the base bar of a BRUV, but it's movable onto the sub.
Yes.
Oh, here we go.
So the submersible dives has given us an opportunity to explore biodiversity in a way in which we haven't previously, and developing the way in which we use the submersibles to become more and more quantitative is something that we want to do in future.
You guys happy?
We've been really fortunate that we've been able to dive the submersible several times on this expedition. So we're gathering a really good picture of what it is that these deep marine habitats look like. There's been lava flows that have extended down to 500 meters. We've had seamounts where we've been able to find some quite unique species.
Oh my gosh.
We've seen a six-gill shark down at depth.
Whoa.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh, it's octopus.
Like what?
Yeah. Oh, it's a red jelly.
Oh, nice.
There is so much diversity down here.
So one of the fish that we found down there is a Grammatinotus, which is an undescribed genus of Calianthidae, which is a splendid perch, which is super exciting. It's this really beautiful small pink fish with a trailing tail fin like this. That just goes to show that the use of subs for biodiversity research is promising, not only for extending depth ranges, but also new records for Samoa and that sort of thing.
Now that we've brought the BRUVs back on board, we're starting to annotate the videos. So we're counting every single fish we see and the different diversity of species we see, so we can get a real good image of assemblage composition. So having two cameras on the BRUV is kind of like having two eyes in the water, and we're able to use those two cameras and our calibrations that we've done prior to the trip to be able to measure the fish. And with that data, we're able to calculate things such as biomass, which is really important for calculating how healthy the reefs are and how old the fish are. It's really good for fishery science.
Once we finish the annotation stage for the BRUVs and we begin reporting, handing back the data to the people of Samoa, we're hoping that it can be used in collaboration with what they already do with protecting their marine resources. They've got an excellent monitoring program already. And this is just another type of method, another data set that they can use, building on top of what they already do.